These lectures are named Plasma Electrolytic Diffusion Saturation of Metals and Alloys with Interstitial Elements. Lecture number one, current passing through aqueous electrolytes. Let us first briefly consider the historical aspect of the issue. For many years, the phenomenon of electrical discharges in liquids attracted the interest of researchers in Russia and Germany. The glow and heating of electrodes with a small surface, anode or cathode, in an electrochemical cell that is at high current densities were discovered as early as 19th century. The first explanation of this phenomenon belongs to Nikolai Sluginov, who discovered two types of luminescence of the platinum wire immersed in electrolyte. In one case, this glow is accompanied by noise and crackling. The current is intermittent. In the other case, the current is continuous. The glow is brighter. If the wire is a cathode, the electrode is surrounded by bubble. The formation of a bubble allowed suggesting similarity to film boiling on the electrode surface. The electrode glow being assumedly caused by the electric charge of the arc type. The first patents for the application of the process were issued in England, France, and Germany. The cathodic heating of parts for their hardening was used in the USSR at Kharkov fracture plant. This method was proposed by Igor Yasnogorodsky. The Japanese patents under the leadership of Inoue Kiyoshi appeared after the World War II. These achievements lay foundation for other development of plasma electrolytic treatment, cathodic quenching in particular. Some of Yasnogorodsky findings are used by contemporary authors as prototypes. The diffusion saturation of metals and alloys with interstitial elements was later investigated by Zhuvanin, USSR, and Inoue Kiyoshi, Japan. Over time, the method was applied in industry of Russia, Ukraine, Belarus, Kazakhstan, and Moldova for anodic high-speed carburization of low carbon and nitriding of medium carbon steels. In the 90s years, the experimental plant of the Academy of Sciences of Moldova has produced dozens of pilot industrial setups, which were used in repair areas of light industry. Physical, electrochemical, and technological features of the plasma electrolytic processing are described in monographs. This relatively long history of the plasma electrolyte technologies are currently undergoing by obvious acceleration. Noteworthy is a review by Alexei Yerohin et al., in which the sufficient amounts is given to physical and electrochemical basis of the phenomenon. The classification of treatment opinions is carried out, and the results obtained are analyzed. This article contains the processes of plasma electrolyte deposition of layers, microarc oxidation of metals and alloys, as well as the saturation with nitrogen and/or carbon. This publication is referred to in almost all the articles which enables to expand plasma electrolytic research internationally. Today, the largest volume of literature belongs to authors from several universities of China, Iran, Tehran, Shiraz and Semnan universities, and Great Britain, Sheffield and Manchester universities. These research teams conduct systematic successive research studies. In addition, certain aspects of plasma electrolyte technologies mainly relate to material science are studied in Australia, Belarus, Germany, India, Spain, Kazakhstan, Moldova, the USSR, Turkey, Japan, Poland, Serbia, Ukraine, France, Chile, Belgium, and South Korea. Pulse technology has become a quantitatively new step in the development of plasma electrolytic treatment, with the opportunity of obtaining nanoscale structures, mainly in the cathode version. Fundamentals of plasma-assisted cathode electrolysis, including pulse current method model, electrolyte composition, and mechanical and electrochemical properties of resulting coatings, were reviewed by Alyov Khazrai et al. This overview contains the feature of the formation of nano-size layer, the condition of their formation, and the properties obtained. In particular, the effect of the character distribution of crystal to their corrosion resistance. The amount of literature related to plasma electrolytic processing is very significant, so its analysis is possible only on a limited number of issues. This lecture is aimed to consider the condition and result of plasma electrolytic saturation of steel and titanium alloys with nitrogen, carbon, and boron, as well as the physical and chemical aspects of the occurrence and existence of electrolysis plasma when the electric layers are not formed on the surface of the electrode and substances from the electrolyte do not participate. Electric current is transferred through aqueous solution of electrolytes by ions formed during the desaturation of various substances. The simplest circuit is a bath filled with electrolyte and two metal electrodes immersed in the electrolyte and connected to the power surface. The electric field of a power source drives it to electrolyte ions and the electrons of metals, and the transfer of the charge through the metal electrolyte interface is generated by the exchange of electrons between the ions and the surface layer of the metal. This exchange causes electrochemical reaction at the interface of electrolyte and electrodes. This process has long been known and widely used in modern industry. The current densities in the electrolyzer vary from 10 ampere per meter square to 10 kiloampere per meter square, depending on the nature of the reactions and the nature of the target product. The passage of current through solution of some salts is accompanied by the electrolysis of water, that is, its decomposition into hydrogen and oxygen. Low values of density of the current passing through aqueous electrolyte are not related to significant heating. Higher current density results in the electrode heating up to its boiling point. This phenomenon can be clearly observed in an electrolysis, where the surface contact area with electrolyte in the electrode is much smaller than that in the other. For example, one of the electrodes is a piece of thin wire. In this case, the main resistance of the electrical circuit will be concentrated in a small region of the electrolyte contacting with the wire. It is here that most of the energy of the power source will be realized, which will lead to local boiling of the electrolyte. As a result, the surface of the electrode with a small surface will be covered with a mixture of vapor and electrolysis gases, which will lead to the opening of the electrical circuit, but not for a long time. The vapor and gaseous envelope condensed, the contact of the electrolyte with the electrode is restored, and the process is repeated. Such a system will work as a pulse generator, which is easy to detect by recording the current with an oscilloscope. Various modes of current passing are usually considered on the current voltage characteristic of the process, sometimes supplemented with a temperature voltage characteristic. According to figures 1 and 2, the characteristic of the passing current depends on the polarity of the electrode with a small surface. U1 is voltage of transfer from conventional electrolysis to the current interruption mode in Fig. 1. Point B in the Fig. 2 shows this transfer. Recurrent formation of the envelope in the region BC and the pulsed current hindered the description of the process taking place in the system with the effective values on current and voltage. Therefore, the vertical segments on the current voltage characteristic in the region BC, Fig. Number 2, are conditional. The reason for the destruction of the envelope is the electric breakdown of the vapor, which causes its explosive expansion and subsequent condensation. The electrode temperature is 100 Celsius degree in the voltage range corresponding to the interruption mode. Intermittent luminescence is created by spark discharges, and the appearance and disappearance of the envelope is accompanied to noise on crackling. Yasnogorodsky, Kellogg, and Sengupta showed that the appearance of discharges current replace luminescence and other observant effects are promoted by vapor generation rather than the gas liberation at the electrode. Further studies showed that the first critical voltage, U1, is associated with the amount of thermal energy required for local boiling of the electrolyte in the near electrode region, followed by the formation of the envelope. Measurements of U1 is in various electrolytes with electrodes from various materials confirmed that the envelope is formed on the electrode with the best boiling condition of the electrolyte, regardless of the polarity and with the negligible role of electrolyte. Regardless of the negligible role of electrolysis gas evolution. As a rule, the envelope is formed on the electrode called active, one with a smaller surface area, ceteris paribus. The second critical voltage, U2, determines the transition from the current interruption mode to the stable state of the envelope and essentially depends on the polarity of the active electrode, Fig 1. The cathodic process is characterized by some electric discharges at the beginning of the decreasing region in the current voltage characteristic. Stabilization of the envelope occurs in the voltage region from U2 to U3. The decreasing character of this characteristic is explained by the increase in the thickness of the envelope and the increase in its resistance due to the intensification of evaporation and the solution as voltage rises. In the case of cathodic process, the voltage increase promotes the rise of the workpiece temperature and can result in the transition from normal glow discharge to an NMOS one and bejoin U3 to an intense arc. A stable system of electrolyte envelope metal electrode is formed when the voltage reaches the second critical value. In this case, the heat flux from the envelope to the electrolyte provides the stable liquid-vapor interface. This release of heat is associated with the passage of electric current of sufficient magnitude through the vapor gaseous envelope. The emission spectrum of the cathode envelope contains the lines of almost all elements of the system. Fig 2 shows the characteristics of the anodic process. The vapor gaseous envelope becomes stable at the point C. The current through envelope is constant with a small pulsation. The temperature of the part sharply increases. The CD region is a high temperature heating mode. The yellow glow of the vapor gaseous envelope corresponds to the spectrum of the heated body. The anodic envelope conductivity in the voltage range from 100 to 300 volts can be related to the emission of the anions of the boiling electrolyte and the envelope and their further transfer to the path under the influence of electric field. The current voltage characteristic decreases just as in the cathodic process. The temperature voltage characteristic has a maximum 260 to 280 volts. The temperature of the parts is sharply reduced at point D, where the current remains practically unchanged. The color of the glow turns blue. Its spectrum contains lines of hydrogen, oxygen, and alkali metals if they are found in the solution. It can be assumed that electric discharges appear in the envelope in the region DE. These discharges lead to the spattering of electrolyte, which cools the part. Probably weak discharges appear even in the CD region. They slightly affect the decrease in the part temperature before point D. The stationary heating mode is convenient for high-speed thermal or chemical thermal processing of small-sized metal products. The heating rate reaches hundreds of degrees per second. The temperature of the path is controlled by the voltage. The disconnection of the voltage results in rapid quenching because the condensation of the envelope ensures the cooling of the parts in the same electrolyte. The presence of nitrogen, carbon, or boron compounds in the electrolyte makes it possible to saturate the details with these elements.